What's good, everybody? Shaolin Pretzels here, and I just wanted to record a really quick disclaimer for this Dragon Punch tournament that you're about to see. There were a couple of moments during the tournament's actual stream time where we lost internet service on my end. That's just a thing that's been happening with my ISP over the course of this week. It just kind of happens. But we were able to record a majority of the tournament in full. So what we have here for you is the tournament footage in full, with us also remedying for those little hiccups that have happened along the way. So, without further delay, enjoy Dragon Punch Online.
Yeah, that was a different week. I did not participate in that.
Yeah. That's what I noticed. Yeah, that was the week you didn't place top four was the week.
There was one week that I entered that was not top four.
Yeah, it was the week the Balrog made top four, I think.
Yep. Alright, so I think we are all set to go. Welcome everybody to Dragon Punch number 10. We're doing a little bit of a pre-show here to kind of run down all the stuff that we've been doing over the past 10 weeks of us being in quarantine. God help us. Okay, so recently I went through and I decided to go and look back at all the things that have happened over the past couple weeks of us running Dragon Punch, and myself and Core Jam have compiled this little bit of data that you see before you. So to kind of help me like run through this, I have Mr. Town Crier and Core Jam himself here in the chat. And we're gonna talk about some of like the key like highlights we've noticed over the course of these past 10 weeks.
Glad to be here.
Yeah, so let's just get right into it. Let's go Akron.
Let's go overall. Akron. Let's go overall. Let's go Akron.
Overall, Akron, and specifically Laura, seems to win this tournament a lot.
Yeah, so if we were to look over at our champions over like the past couple DPOs, so overall...
We have three of them.
We have three of... Yes, so as you can see, the city of Akron has won five DPOs over the course of these past 9 weeks. Will it happen again? You guys find out.
I'm not entering this week.
Unlikely.
Unlikely. We'll see if the other Akron boys put in some work. But also, we have Columbus pulling in with three wins, thanks to Mr. One Life to Play Hitman. And Toledo with the single win. That's a special
coming
thanks
out,
to Mr. Mustafis.
Out of the multiple day. Like the multiple Akuma mirrors we had that day.
That day should not have happened. There should not have been that many Akumas. There should not have been that many Geefs. Why was there a Zeku in top four? So many questions.
That day was something special. I saw Kyle play. It was great.
Dragon Punch 8 was weird. Let's just leave it at that.
the data here that we're seeing, it's no surprise. I mean, chances are any Dragon Punch Online, the winner is going to be either myself or Hitman. And that's really just reflective of how Ohio Street Fighter V has been for the past year and a half. So it's not too surprising to see that.
That is very
true. But with neither of you two entering, it means unless Mistopheles can make the run, we're gonna have a new champion.
A brand new champion for Dragon Punch 10 coming in to get that $50.
Already have a few top four placers in this bracket. However, only Mustafli is able to take the crown. I'd be excited.
It's going to be very hard for him. He specifically struggles against Birdie, and Sedman is playing. Sedman, on the same caliber as myself and Hitman, usually just doesn't clutch it out quite when he needs to. He's had two second place finishes and one third place, I think. But very good, very strong, and I expect him to win this tonight, honestly.
Yeah, looking over at the entrance page.
He'd be a reasonable money favorite.
Looking over at the entrance page for Setman, he's entered three DPOs, and of those three DPOs that he's entered, he's made it to top four in all of them, and two of those were grand finals placings. He just didn't clutch it out. I think you actually played him both times, Corey, when he ended up in grand finals.
Yeah, the first one, which was Dragon Punch 1, he actually had to DQ himself at the very end there because he had to run to the store before it closed. But, right. You know, it goes.
it's just life. And,
yeah, and then the last week where you beat him.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got the run back from Dragon Punch 1 that we never ended up getting. Also, just kind of looking at these, like, at these top four placements. I'm gonna sort these by the top fours. There are a lot of interesting names that were found when we were doing the specifically the people who got top four at previous Dragon Punches. A lot of people have gotten that position once and just haven't gotten it again. And I accidentally sorted the wrong column. Let me fix that.
And a pretty wide breadth of characters have made top four here.
Yeah, that's also very true. Not fully expressed here, although I would really like to do that at some point. Maybe I'll do that next week. We have a bunch of like people here who have only made top four once. We have the likes of David Swoops, Shin Goon, Green Ranger, Blaze 007, Team Cleveland's own Ultimate Vitality, Iron Zangief, Black Sage, and Little Guru. And a bunch of these are names that I'm surprised that have only entered this tournament once, because there's quite a few killers here.
You have to look at who typically is in the top four. It's usually myself, Hitman, Dante, or Mistopheles, or Sedman. So of those five, assuming they're entered, there's a very high chance that they're going to be in top four. And they're all players who enter quite a bit. So really, to get a top four finish, you're competing for one slot.
Right.
So it doesn't surprise me that we see a lot of people who've only done it once. And we don't have too many people who enter a bunch of DPOs. I think looking at the spreadsheet here, looks like most people have entered three, maybe four times. So, you know, it's going to be rough.
That is also very true. One specific individual that I'm actually kind of surprised hasn't, like, just barely clutched it out yet in terms of like winning a DPO would be THTB. He's currently the individual with the most top four finishes, but the least tournament wins.
Yeah, and that just speaks to Dante's consistency in always being able to place top four. It's just he runs into the hard walls that are myself, Hitman, and Sedman, usually.
Yeah. And he didn't enter the 1 week, I think. I would have put him most likely to win.
Right. I'm just looking over at the graphics real quick. He placed third at Dragon Punch 2, second place at Dragon Punch 3 to Hitman. Let's see, he placed fourth in Dragon Punch 5, fourth in Dragon Punch 6. So yeah, so and also fourth last week for Dragon Punch 9. So yeah, he's very consistent. At the very least, just has to get it over those like last little bit of bumps in the road in order to actually get the win.
They're not so much bumps in the roads as they are just like craters.
One of them happening to be named Birdie this week.
One of them happened to be named Birdie.
I mean, with since it's really just like Sedman being the big heavy hitter, the only one of the big heavy hitters entering, I think we're gonna see a lot of surprises. We have a pretty big bracket tonight with a lot of faces, a lot of faces we don't usually see, so I'm excited to see who we might have in the top four.
And having a look at the bracket real quick, I'm gonna refresh it in case we had someone else enter. Okay, yeah, we do have a 16-man bracket this week.
I gotta fix that then.
So looking at the names that are in the bracket, we have Sedman versus Pen Knight, Iron Zangief versus Necrokali.
He's not going to be correct with Pen Knight,
Pen Knight would be higher seed for sure.
Okay. Football to the Go Nats, we have not started just yet. We're currently doing a little bit of a pre-show, kind of running through all the stuff that's going on. If you're in the state of Ohio and you would like to enter Dragon Punch Online,
get rid of me.
If you would like to enter Dragon Punch Online this week, be sure to type in the command !DPO in the chat, and upon doing so, you will get access to the information that you need in order to actually join. Not in the state of Ohio feels bad, man. It's all good, dude.
Met you, Custin. Wish you could be here.
Ready? Yeah. Live already?
Yeah.
Yep.
I am sorry. I will. Bye.
No, you're good.
You're good, Max. You're good.
It happens sometimes. So what was it? It was last week? Did you talk to Hitman before about doing commentary, or did he just jump in the channel and start doing it?
He talked to me about it in the Twitch chat, and then I said it was okay.
Okay. I was just wondering, because I was like, wait.
Sky Guy, you're good, you're good. So just going off of the names, not really so much the seating for tonight's bracket, we have Sedman. Okay. Let me just refresh the bracket so we actually have the proper seeds. And you guys are seeing
Sedman versus our boy Big Moisture.
Big Moist.
Is he?
If you want to add money to the pot, just PayPal me.
Is Big Moisture the Guile? I don't remember.
Corey, do you actually want me to create like a command if you want to add like money to the pot?
Or do you just... I don't think that's going to be a normal thing. I wouldn't worry about it.
Okay. I guess one thing that could kind of work. Football to go Nets. I do have a command for that I typically use for donations, but I can use it for the prize pool for tonight. So exclamation point tip. If you really feel compelled to add money to the pot, that would be very appreciated, and I'm pretty sure our players would appreciate it as well. If you want to add something to the pot, exclamation point tip.
Or PayPal now, me. He has my PayPal. I don't care either way.
Okay.
It's winner take all right now, right?
Yeah. Yes. $50 that's being the prize pool for each game is specifically meant for the winners of each game.
Yep.
Just because I think... Like, we could have divided it up between first, second, and third and make it like 30, 15, 5.
Yeah, but it's...
No one ever feels good winning $5 or 15. You know, you want to say you won the 50.
Right. Gotta win that. Gotta win that big wing money.
Big wing money.
All right, let's look over this again real quick. So again, just based off of the seeding, Sedman, Big Moisture, Iron Zangief, Necrokali, David Swoops, Gorgameth, THDB, Pen Knight, Mr. Mistopheles, Rumaster, which I still have no idea where this dude's from, Dark Zeo versus Bloodback McGrath, Ultimate Vitality versus Jack Vegeta, Hambone versus Mr. Headache. That is your winner's round one for Dragon Punch 10.
So, like, the most important matchup in round one is, like, what, Iron Zangief versus Necrokali, probably? That's seeding-wise and as far as, like, what I would consider to be their skill levels from what I've seen, I think they're pretty comparable.
I'd be interested to see how Iron Zangief would fare against Sedman, but
yeah.
At the end of the day, I'm pretty sure Sedman would probably take it just based off of his, like, skill as a player.
And I think this, and there are some things that probably aren't the most accurate for seeding, but things have been moved around slightly to prevent too many people from fighting the same people from their scene, so keep that in mind.
That's also very true. That's a thing we definitely have to be worried about.
I think THTB Pen Knight will also be pretty interesting, especially if Pen Knight's been working on his conversions and fixing up the holes we saw in this gameplay a few weeks ago. I think that could be closer than might be initially expected. So those are the two matchups I'd look for in round one for sure. Any others that stick out to you guys? Anything you want to do?
In round one, yeah, there's not too much. I think a lot of these are going to be kind of one-sided just because that's how round one typically goes. Round two is going to be a bloodbath, though.
I'd be interested to see the master versus the student, Ultimate Vitality versus Mr. Headache. Headache had a really solid run at Queen City Fights earlier this week. He placed third place in a bracket that had, like, what? Like, didn't, like, Sedman and Hitman enter that bracket as well?
Uh, Say that again? I'm sorry.
I'm talking about the top four placement for Queen City fights. Ultimate Vitality's in the chat, so he'll probably give like a better indication of like how those top four placements kind of went. Yeah, I'd be interested.
I don't remember off the top of my head.
I'll be interested to see how that turns out, though. Okay, so Ultimate Vitality just confirmed. The top four placements for Queen City fights was Hitman, Sebman, Headache, and Gorgameth. So, honestly, I'm really impressed with Headache's loser's run. He beat Mistopheles, he beat Gorg, he unfortunately beat me. I'm gonna get the run back eventually. But, yeah, I'm interested to see how those two would fare should they face each other round two, which is looking like it could be the case. Mr. Mistopheles versus, honestly, like, Darkzeo or Bloodbath. I don't think he's played against either of these two. I'd imagine not.
You know what? That's going to be a good round one match, actually.
Darkzeo versus Bloodbath?
They might have played once or twice, but nothing too concrete, and I think they're on relatively the same skill level.
That should be interesting, then.
Headache is the Kage, right?
Yes.
Yes. The Kage from Cincinnati.
He also plays a little bit of Honda, but Kage is his tournament character.
Yeah, I think I'm excited to see Vitality play in general. I actually don't think I've watched or commentated a DPO that he's actually played in.
It's interesting that you say that, because I think whenever I looked over the stats for how many DPOs that Vitality's entered, he's only entered three. So,
yep.
So the least out of, like, all the other members of Team Cleveland, if you exclude, of course, True God.
He's been surprisingly absent from all of these online tournaments. Someone doesn't like it, or what?
I'm surprised about that, too. Has David been competing that much recently?
Not really. Street Fighter, I don't think it's been his focus regardless.
Fair enough. Am I even on that list? Sky Guy, you are on the list. You entered once. That's all I have to say about that.
I looked through the thing and I am still the worst player as far as entering DPO goes.
Oh my
god. Yeah, we do have leaderboards.
We have a leaderboards as well. I'm showing them on stream right now. So
just don't show page 2.
Oh, page 2? Yeah, of course I'll show page 2. Page 2. 49.
I am literally like, what, 45 points behind the second worst.
Oh god. But yeah, if you look at our top 10 of the leaderboards, we have Core Jam, Mr. Mistopheles, Hitman, Sebman, a lot of mans, THGB, David Swoops, Ultimate Vitality, J Money, Big Boots, and Blaze. Those are our glorious top 10 competitors currently in the Ohio FGC, at least in regards to Dragon Punch.
Since we've seen J Money.
Yeah, J Money lives over in Chicago, so he only enters whenever he can.
Yeah.
And when he did enter, he entered like 2 weeks in a row, and I think he got top four both weeks.
Yep.
Looking over the bracket again, I'm kind of surprised that Mistopheles is actually above Hitman in terms of the rankings.
Mistopheles has entered more than Hitman. I mean, these are based off of ELO rankings, which really don't mean anything in the amount we've played so far. ELO really only starts being, like, a real factor when you start playing, like, hundreds of games.
Right.
So there is going to be variations here, especially since not everyone has played the same amount of times.
That would make sense.
It's really more so just for fun. I don't think anyone should take these rankings seriously.
Of course.
I think it's also might just be due to Record versus Corey specifically. It's probably a big influence because I think Mistopheles has a stat over you. I'm pretty sure.
Possibly.
He's played you less than Hitman.
He has two over me, actually. But I think I'm up three, and Hitman's beaten me a similar amount of times too, so.
Yeah,
it's not like
the numbers might just be in his favor due to the system.
There's a 20-point difference. Like, that's nothing.
Yeah.
Right.
It's go time.
All right. So I think with that, I think it's about time we get started with the tournament, trying to figure out who's going to be our round one opponents.
Yes. And real quick, thanks to a donation from one person whose name is Keston.
One Vega player.
He doesn't play Vega. He plays Azale.
Bang. No.
He donated an extra $50 to the prize pool tonight.
Okay, so now we have a $100 prize pool. I'm going to go ahead and update the stream title right about now.
Thanks,
whether we should do a top three or if that just also goes to first place. I'll figure it out in a little bit.
Yeah, okay, we'll get the logistics of that sorted out. But thank you so much, Keston, for the generous donation to the prize pool. Okay, let's have a look here. According to our glorious TL, Mr. Big Boss, we got Iron Zangief and Necrokali as the first match on stream. So this should be interesting.
Yeah, this is seeding wise, and I think on paper, probably the closest matchup in round one.
I didn't catch that. I'm sorry. Who's going first?
Iron Zangief versus Necrokali.
I would have actually liked to have seen Dark Zero versus Bloodbath, but this is probably going to be a good match too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ideally, I want to see THTB versus Pen Knight, because I think that'll be closer than it looks on paper. But this one, I think this is a safe pick.
Now we have Iron Zangief, who's most definitely going to play Geef, as his name implies. Necrokali, though, will normally play as Alex, but he might opt for his Fang. We'll have to see.
I have seen him pull out his Fang like pretty like early in brackets, just to kind of like get a couple of really quick wins. So
I don't think I've actually ever seen Alex fight Zangief.
I'm pretty sure it's bad for Alex.
Generally speaking, a lot of prep lose to Geef. I don't know what's good for Alex, to be honest.
It's not a lot, unfortunately.
Like, Falk, maybe?
No.
That still seems hard.
Trust me, I live that life. Like, occasionally I'll get gimmicked, but in terms of, like, everything else about the character, nah.
Yeah, I actually don't know which matchups I'd say are, like, super heavily favored to Alex right now. Oh, wait, that was wrong. There we go. Yeah, regardless, expected grappler matchup coming up. Geef on one side, either Fang or Alex on the other. Necrokali, a purveyor of less played characters, I'd say.
Yeah, we actually haven't seen Necrokali in quite a bit. He's missed out on the past couple of Dragon Punches. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see if he's come back with fresh perspective.
Seeing what he brings to the table, and character-wise, it's going to be the Alex. So opting for the grappler versus grappler matchup.
I feel like this is the match that he's most comfortable with.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm glad he went with Alex, even though it's probably a harder matchup for him as opposed to Fang. I think that Alex is significantly better.
Yeah, gotta go with what you know.
Yeah. Oh, went for the EX grab, which really sucks. There's a couple of grapplers who have rules like that, but they all lose when your opponent doesn't attack on their knockdowns.
Yeah, well, the smarter times when you can just wait it out. Getting
you can poke all using crouching light punch. Could just try and outpoke Keith, which is not a bad
strategy. Tornado connects!
It's not a bad strategy, but Geese is better, I think, in most regards. So he can just outpoke you with the same button you're trying to outpoke Geek with.
Yeah, it's got some long limbs. Doesn't quite have the mobility of Alex, but has a lot of frustrating options in his own right.
Yeah, most definitely. Wow, what a crush counter. The hitbox on that is so atrocious.
EX Stomp gets him in.
Good crush counter. Guess we're getting right here. No, I thought Geek's EX SVD was about to beat that.
Probably so. So tired. Looks like you could use more training. But yeah, Necro probably able to green out, even up the game. Zangief a little bit more far, but you've got to say, the momentum's probably in Necrocali's favor.
He went for the third time? Man, Necrocali's crazy.
He went for it the third time and spent the bar on it. Tokido took 5 grabs in a row, you're gonna take this. Oh,
it is correct.
Ooh. Might have been a little bit due to the lag, but won't connect there. Game's in the hands of whoever connects the first.
Well, Necrocali can take at least one more hit.
Oh, no. But he won't have to.
Nice. Necrocali goes up one game.
Alex wins.
Very nice showing.
After the lag causes the little drop earlier.
But no, yeah, it is looking a little laggy, which is unfortunate. I'm seeing some other people in Discord saying that it's being laggy for them too.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, this has to be what, pretty much peak internet hours right now? Fight!
The internet has been trash for a lot of people today, which is unfortunate that it's just how things have lined up.
Yeah, it was like that for me yesterday, too.
Everyone's trying to download the last ever Terraria patch. I don't know.
As they say, the show must go on. They're playing in this for money.
I can't wait to play in this for an Evo title.
Yes.
Nice hit grab. Oh no. It's hit by the booth.
All those lessons you learned and then
reset.
Unlearned.
Very unfortunate whiff on the SPD on the side of Mr. Tinder Troll.
Krakali's getting a lot of mileage off of those EX grabs. And I feel like it's because of the conditions they're playing in.
It happens.
Yeah, it's unfortunate. But you know, you gotta adapt to what the game is giving you.
That is true.
Time.
How quickly can you relearn your online strats? What got you out of gold will take you far in here.
There is a difference, a hard difference between offline fundamentals and online fundamentals.
It's
as
like
Hytania taught me. And the EX stun gun. Oh, unfortunate whip on the SPD.
Only able to get the medium. Oh, hey!
Just goes for it. That's the answer.
Alright. Into the ground he goes.
Oh dear lord.
Come at me with more this time. Round to Zangief.
Spent all the butter, but if he gets it around.
Ooh, it jumps right into his arms.
Snuffs out what I assume to be EX slash elbow. Oh
just
no.
Able to trade with some pokes.
My heart goes out to everyone playing tonight.
We chose a good night to not enter.
Usually not like this, honestly.
It usually
We restrict it specifically to wire
prevent
connections
this.
In Ohio. Everyone in here is in Ohio. Ethernet, like this. It's not our fault.
Zangief,
which sucks.
We take as many precautions as we can. But
hey, tied game. Yeah. That's what we like to see. Close matches.
Round one.
Whoever's playing Ken's going to win. Good lord.
You know?
It really do be like that.
I actually don't think we have a single Ken player, period.
There is one in Columbus.
Okay, so there's one Ken Columbus.
Lord of the Lag, who definitely win this if he wins it.
Lord of the Lag.
Someone should have hit him up in the DMs and said $100.
No, he's actually, he's banned from playing.
Okay. He should disqualify.
What? That was weird. Alright.
Mysterious invader.
Ooh. Max with the... Would you call that parry? It makes a parry sound.
Kinda.
Almost feels more like armored move or focus attack. But it's a parry noise.
You call it when you want to.
I'm sure it has a name, but I've never played Alex, so I never tried to learn it. Ooh, connects with a slash. Decent life lead for Alex, but he's pretty good at taking this away. Has an entire bar to do it.
Duffed by the Lariat. No conversion.
Oh no.
Oh no, spaghetti everywhere.
Could be reversal. That's what you want to do there. Just don't even deal with any of the mix-ups you can do.
Ooh. Oh, whiff on the command grab. That's what resets.
That's with a knee. Won't get the second one. Life's pretty much evened up.
You can see, Zangief, excuse me. You can see the Geek player, he was specifically trying to bait the EX grab from Alex.
Okay.
Oh no, conversion, but he gets the SBD!
No. The V-trigger will cost him everything. And Zangief takes it 2-1.
Well fought. Well fought, Henry.
Well fought in these conditions.
It's go time.
Okay, let's take things back to the bracket. Have a look at who we're probably gonna be having up next. Seeing how everyone else is doing.
Have THTB versus the legend David Swoops.
David Swoops.
So, Sakura versus Abigail.
Yes.
All right. Okay.
David Swoops. If you play online, you might be familiar with that name in the Diamond Plus bracket. He is infamous for one and dunning literally everyone. No matter. To his words, it's a way of life, and I respect the snot out of it.
Wow.
Stand by your doctrine, whatever the doctrine may be.
Man of principle.
A man knows what he is.
This is a man who knows what he wants in life.
And what he wants in white.
He wants to take your battle points and leave.
Just puts it in God's hands and sees what happens.
Based on the quality of the internet, this tournament's in God's hands, so... He's in a good position.
Hopefully it starts stabilizing a bit. Maybe that was just a fluke. One can hope.
It's always possible that someone specific's internet just isn't up to it today, but...
Yep.
Hopefully it does not reflect on the remaining quality of the tournament.
We shall do our best with what we have.
We'll do everything in our power, which, to be honest, isn't a lot.
We don't have much control over this.
We already are doing everything in our power.
Round one.
Stages restricted. Regions restricted.
Restricted.
Wired connection restricted.
As much as we can control the wired connections.
We're doing as much as we can without sending Corey to everyone's house.
And a step I will not take. There is a line.
We're having a webcam pointed at everyone's router.
Ooh, no conversion.
This is looking significantly better.
Yes.
Yeah, this is not
that good. That's good. Gives me hope.
Nice decision going for the air-to-air after the fireball.
Ooh, irreversible, not gonna do it. Okay.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. The damage trade. And he busts out with the EXDP, not quite enough to kill. So there's one small sliver of health left. David Smooth still has V-Trigger 2.
He dashes forward, he eats the fireball. And
round two. All Smooth had to do was do super in his face, and it was over.
That was horrifying. This is why I hate this character. Nice air fireball.
Able to connect with the combo.
It's the HDB special.
Whew. EXDPs.
Against a character that just gets a bunch of armor on his move, if you have a multi-hit DP, you're much better in the matchup.
Yep. Whiff punishing with DPs like a Ken player, let's go.
Online tactics. Good.
Apparently,
you need to just block it out. That's what you want to do. Getting flipped is not worth it.
Yeah. Good air to air on the side of Mr. Swoops.
Swoops is one of the
Oh god! That last little clip.
You should have just blocked.
Jumped.
Now you're gonna die.
Oh, okay. Answers with the XDP. Gets him out of the corner. Crush. Could be it.
Hey.
Critical Art not quite able to end him. The jump doesn't end up costing him the game.
It should have,
Dante.
Dante, we love you, but you should have died.
Yeah, that's nightmare fuel.
Yeah. Swoops is one of the only Abigails I ever see that does his little stance into the roll back.
Yeah.
Interesting. I've never asked him why he does it, but I'd be curious to know.
I've seen Guru do that a couple of times whenever I played him. It's an interesting playstyle choice.
Ooh, gets the cross up.
A good jump in.
Damage.
What a Ooh, good shimmy.
Good damage. Oh no. Abigail able to get out of the corner. Answered with an EXDP.
Crush.
You can see THCD just really trying to rely on Sakura's ability to stay out of range of Abigail's buttons.
So consistent. Able to punish everything that Abigail's been throwing. One way or the other, whether it be EXDP or one of those combos. Dante is a very consistent player.
Reversing with the EXDP every chance he gets.
He will consistently EXDP.
He will consistently EXDP.
Oh, there we go, Swoops.
Throw out your own EX.
He doesn't care about the plus frames. He's just going to punch through them.
Yep. Not able to get the best use out of the tire.
Pretty much get over the fireball. Bad use of flip. You get punished.
Oh, and the crush.
Ooh.
That's an interesting route.
That's fancy. I like it.
Gets clipped by the crouching heavy kick. swoops in activation, goes to the overhead, almost went for a second one, gets interrupted by THTB.
Super there, could have won it.
Very true.
Might have tried before chip out.
Just don't jump.
THTB could chip here. But the trade will do it. HDB.
Fireball.
Sakura wins.
The THDB moving on to winners round three. My man played with fire, but he made it out all right.
Yeah, that was, I'd say interesting from David Sweeps. He took tire, but pretty much only was able to call it in, like, roughly two times. Opting to try to keep up the pressure more than good for more intricate setups or occupy the
stage. Yeah, I mean, that tire is really degenerate, but you have to be really careful when just doing it in neutral. A lot of the times, Abigail players will have to give up Oki to just get the tire down, which, I mean, does give them some more set plays, so it is still kind of Oki, but a lot of... you can't normally just throw it out for free. A lot of characters do have answers for it.
Yeah.
So I'm being told that the next players that we're going to be having on stream are going to be Mr. Mistopheles and Dark Zero Omega.
Okay. Kuma versus Vega. Interesting matchup. It's not one I see too often.
The last time we saw this was... or the last time I saw this had to be... what, like DPO 4 or 5 when J-Money entered, I think?
Possibly.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
probably been the last time I saw Vega versus Akuma. I don't think I've seen these two specifically play, but I might be wrong. And they're off. The expectation has to be Akuma versus Vega. They're pretty much character specialists. I don't think... at least as far as I know, neither of them have secondaries that we should be looking
at. I have never seen either of these characters play anything but the two characters are going to pick. Ever. Not once. And some people are like that, and it's completely fine.
It's better to be loyal to some characters than others.
Yeah.
If you find a character you like, might as well stick with it.
I wish I loved Akuma as much as Mistopheles loved Akuma.
I wish no one loved Akuma as much as Mistopheles loved Akuma.
And so going right in, both of them sticking with the default kit, the way these characters were on day one.
Fight!
So in this matchup, I think Dark Zero is really just going to try and stay right outside of Mr. Mistopheles' stand medium kick range and just try and poke him out. That's all Vega can really do. And if Dark Zero gets the knockdown, he can try and use the plethora of set play options that Vega has to try and mix him up.
Yeah, it looks like when Dark Zero is opting to get a little too aggressive.
Yeah, that's
awfully to punishing correctly.
Yeah, you have to. You can't mess up against Akuma. You can't mess up against anyone, really, but Akuma has a lot of tools to just punish any slip up you might have.
Good damage by Dark Zero.
Yep, evening things up in terms of life.
Back to even.
Keep and activate. Alright, Cloud's gone.
It's
responded an air throw. Very nice.
Stupid.
That is the answer to that one.
Oh, no.
But it was all for nothing.
Air throw, the demon flip. Eat the combo for the rest of your life.
Yep.
No bar left for Akuma, but round one in the soft ways.
Very nice side switch on the side of Mr. Mistopheles. Goes for it again. Conversion off that counter hit crouch medium punch.
Is this Kage? Is this Ken? No, it's Akuma. Even scarier.
Demon flip into the slide. Good choice.
Log on.
Once again.
Won't be able to poke himself back in. won't be able to do much at all. A little bit of life.
Dark Zero starting to make a little bit of a comeback. Goes for the flip, but the back fierce anti-air from Mr. Mistopheles is gonna take it.
Akuma wins.
He's been in the lab. The reason we haven't seen Goon is because Mistopheles absorbed him. His anti-airs are off point.
we'll say that when Mistopheles starts cross-cutting. When he starts cross-cutting, then I'll believe it.
Round one. Fight!
Okay, so Dark Zero deliberately going to not use Claw for the opening portion of this match.
Yeah, probably wanting to keep it for the end. Feeling a bit more comfortable. But...
Ooh, missed the light confirm there. I think he could have gone into a roll.
Yeah. Mustafli is missing on the air fireball. Nice sequence of punishes from Mr. Dark Zero. Blocks EX DP.
No punish. That is minus 5, and when Kuma does that, you get a free punish. Granted, I try and do it online, and I just eat another DP right after.
So Dark Zero almost gone. Nice tech, but gets clipped by the crouching medium kick.
Round 2.
Sophocles, one more round. Starting it off right. Good combo into Demon Form.
Yeah, Mistopheles relentlessly going on the offensive. Spotting in kind with the better back fears.
Ooh,
ooh, very nice, very nice teleport on the side of Mr. Mistopheles. So Dark Zero getting the crush. Slowly working Mistopheles into the corner. And some Mistopheles building up his corner pressure. Zero still has the claw. Okay, never mind.
And it's gone.
It's like, and it's gone. And the mask is gone too. So, Zero with a huge amount of gray life.
There's some like weird properties that happens only when the mask is off. Doesn't he like take slightly more damage or something?
I think so. Because they wanted this character to be bad. I don't know. And with that, Mistopheles takes it 2-0 over Dark Zero.
More damage or not, I'd say that was probably enough. 2-0 to Mistopheles.
Very impressive showing from Toledo's own Mr. Mistopheles.
It's go time.
Yeah, looking clean.
Alright, let's have a look at the bracket again and see what's up.
Ooh, Mistopheles versus Vitality.
Ooh, that should be a really interesting match for winner's side of top 8. Looking over at the loser's bracket, since I don't feel like we've been paying enough attention to that, Jack Ahita versus Garland FTD. This is a new guy.
He slid in there at the last moment. I have no idea who he is.
I think
he didn't even show up, because if you look at the match previously, it's 0-0, which implies
no Hambone didn't show up.
Oh. I mean, they both might not have shown up, and
that's possible.
The GO just moved one of them forward.
Interesting. Garland appeared to play. I don't know. We also got Pen Knight Gorgameth going on losers. Necrocolly Big Moisture as well in losers.
Why would you use that tag?
Ask Dom.
I told you it's a reference.
Oh, that's right. I'm getting some major deja vu right now. I do remember this conversation.
The thing is, I don't remember. Was Big Moisture the Guile?
I think that was the Guile.
Okay, next up we're gonna have Mistopheles versus Vitality on stream.
Alright, so
bringing the Akuma back. Introducing a jury.
Introducing a jury. Yep, Cincinnati's own Ultimate Vitality. the last jury of Ohio, since somebody decided to stop playing the character.
I might go back. I no longer have, like, the bad, like... I no longer have bad muscle memory with her, since I have no muscle memory anymore. Yeah, one of my favorite players in Ohio, for sure. So, we'll see. We'll see what happens here.
Now, traditionally, I think Mephistopheles has edged out on Vitality, but it's usually always a really close match. So it should be a good show.
This is one of the ones I'd be... If I looked at this bracket, this is one of the ones I'd say I'm the most excited for.
Sure.
On the other side of winners, we'll have the winner of Iron Zangief and Sebman versus Dante, who's waiting for them.
I'm actually curious what's going to be going on with Sebman versus Iron Zangief.
It's going to probably be a Geef mirror, honestly, because that's what Sebman likes to do.
Round one.
I think we got one Geef mirror out of Chancho versus Zangief, I think, once, but...
Did they play?
I think so. I know we've seen a Geef mirror and that Alp was in it.
Hmm. Anyway, let's not talk about that match, let's talk about this one.
Yeah, so, Vitality is really just going to try and stay right outside of Akuma's range. They have pretty similar walk speed, so I think Akuma's is a little bit better. But Juri's stand medium kick, I think, outclips a lot of what Akuma's trying to do, except maybe Akuma's crouching heavy punch. That might be the big gotcha that Vitality has to look out for. But outside of that...
Now the game begins.
Yeah, this is actually going to be like a very...
Oh no.
Drop.
You trigger one Juri as an anime character.
Ooh, very precariously landed and blocked the fireball.
Ooh, okay.
And clipped by the overhead. Very sad.
He doesn't get tilted from that situation.
He brought a lot of damage back.
Yeah, I mean, that's what Akuma does. As soon as he activates V-Trigger, you get clipped once, you're eating 300 into OP.
I was talking about the Juri conversion, but that's also true. Yeah. Able to
very nice DPs.
Ooh, another drop. That's unfortunate, but I don't think Mephistopheles knows the correct punish for that, since he went for the throw.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Oh.
Opting to try pinwheel.
Goes for the activation.
Yeah, that move is dangerous to go for.
Oh, no conversion into DP. Is it a DP?
I think that only works with EX DP, and he didn't have the meter for it.
That might be it. Oh gets clipped.
And away he goes.
Instant air, two hitting fireball that leads into a full combo into super.
Couldn't be me. People thought this character dropped a tier. People are insane.
But the thing is, I think... I don't know if this is true in DT1, but normally if you block an instant air fireball, the Akuma's gonna be minus when he falls to the ground. But with VT1 air fireball being two hits, the frame data might be different. Oh my goodness.
Oh god. Charging right up in this man's face. DP gets clipped.
This is atrocious, what we're seeing, honestly.
That fierce anti-air into the corner. Vitality slowly bringing it back with Feng Shui conversions. Slowly pushing Mephistopheles to the opposite end of the screen. Opting to go for the charge. Nice use of it right then and there.
Let the anime begin.
Good pick grab.
Yep.
Good job on Vitality for keeping his composure.
Round two.
Fight. Ultimate Vitality, recovering all that ground he lost in the first game.
Some good damage.
The scary thing about Akuma is because of how fast his walk speed is and how easy it is to get clipped by staying medium kick, it's real easy to get yourself walked into the corner. And then from there, he gets to just bully you.
Oh my god!
Anti-aired and then blown up.
Blown sky high. Alright, so Vitality responds with a pressure sequence into VT activate. Back throw from Stoffley's.
Dree has the damage to bring this back. He's gonna have to find a way to get it in.
That was a brave fireball throw. Considering Stoffley's knows Vitality had V-Skill ready.
Yeah,
V-Skill 1 charges up, but...
Vitality just not ready to respond. Yeah.
Good whiff on the car and stop lead.
Back throw to keep him in the corner. Or forward throw.
Forward, DX kicks. Grabbed out of the overhead, very nice.
I feel like Mustafa didn't need to do an overhead there, though it could be wrong. That just seems like not a spot to do an overhead.
He'd trigger one, there you go.
To jump really into block. Very nice on the side of Ultimate Vitality.
Now, contrary to what the life bars might say, it was that game state right there was actually even.
Jury win.
But Vitality managed to clip Mustafa's toes and seal it.
Indeed. 1-1.
1-2-1.
If Vitality can keep his composure, and if no more unlucky drops, which I think I saw like 5 of them in the past 2 games, which were all situations where they seemed like they should have worked, I think Vitality has a good shot taking this, but he's just got to keep his composure.
Yeah, both of these two are very fundamentally solid players. It's just a matter of like which one of them can retain their patience more so than the other.
Keep up the composure, keep out that medium kick. So far, able to get a pretty good life lead off of decent amount of pokes, EX pinwheel with the neck. Yeah, it does.
Wow, and Detray with a fireball kept Mustafis from getting an additional conversion.
I don't think that was intentional, but that's some tech that if I were Vitality, I'd review and see how I could use that later on.
Alright.
Alright. Oh, bust out with the EXDP. He wanted that round really bad.
Round two.
Mind trigger in my face. That was a mistake. EX pinwheel. EP, good damage.
Hey.
Crossover into the side switch, that's what you want. But again, Akuma's walk speed and buttons are so oppressive that Mustafa's had no issue getting back into neutral.
Oh, that's a walk out of the range.
Ooh, missed the hit from there, that could have sealed it, though I think that was only one hit.
That should be it, yep.
Well, on the last round, the last game, to determine who's going to ascend to winner's finals.
Everything's even but the bar.
I think that's minus enough that Mustafa could have done a real punish.
Possibly.
Get the sweep. Vitality's in trouble. For a much more distanced game plan. Mustafa's almost feeling like he's playing the keep up.
Yeah, I mean, that's what you want to do when you're in the lead. You want to give your opponent every opportunity to fail.
Awesome.
missed the hit from there, that could have been huge.
Ultimate Vitality. Ooh, trying to play things.
Another missed hit confirmed.
Couple of really like loose pokes.
A little nervous.
Yeah, not canceling the second hit of medium kick.
And Mistopheles is slowly building up V-Gauge.
Get the projectile on the ground.
Oh, and that's gonna do it.
I don't think I agree with that B-trigger activation, because that's that you have to get him chipped out off of any light hit. But it didn't matter anyways, because he got clipped.
The Mr. Mistopheles taking it.
Fought.
It's go time.
Mistopheles able to find
really
his
unfortunate.
Ammo.
There were so many...
So many drops. Okay, let's have a look
in
at
situations
the...
like that, so you just see it.
That's one of the downsides of the character for sure.
God.
So in winners finals, we will have. Oh, okay.
Give me a sec.
No problem. So in winners finals, we'll be having Mistopheles versus the winner of Subman and THTV. On losers, we've got Vitality waiting for the winner of David Swoops and either Iron Zangief or Bloodbath McGrath. And on the other side, Gorgameth is currently waiting for the winner of Dark Zero and Big Moisture. While we go
live right now, I don't think we are.
I'm working on that. ISP issues.
Oh, I thought I just dropped from the lobby.
Nah, you're good. I'll go ahead and reinvite everyone. I have the VOD recorded, so even if like there's issues with like the stream later, I still have the VOD.
My internet's been remarkably consistent during this. I'm very grateful.
It's go time.
Alright, my sincere apologies to the stream audience for that. My ISP has been acting up since yesterday, so I'm not really so sure what's going on with that. I believe next on stream we'll be having Setman versus THTB. So I'm gonna go ahead and get those two in here right about now.
It's likely Sakura Birdie.
Type that one in, because that one is... Alright, just gonna wait for the all okay from the... the stream, just to make sure things are working again.
Subman here awaiting the arrival of THTB.
Yep, we're just waiting on Dante and then we'll be good to go. All right, I think that we've fully recovered. Yep, again, my mistake. Internet providers being weird. Might actually have to look into changing that over the next couple months.
Yeah, I'll have to assume it's going to be Birdie versus Sakura. But
have these two fought in the past? I'm gonna send them another invite.
Fought? I think so. Recently, no. Unless I fought last week, which I guess is possible. I wasn't here.
That is entirely true. Let me think. Let me have a look at the top four graphics. I feel like if those two would have fought, they probably would have fought somewhere like around like top four. Unless seeding, because you know that happens.
So they probably didn't face each other unless it was last week or week one.
I don't think they have. I'm not seeing it. Yeah. A
bit hard to say.
Still waiting on the arrival of Mr. THTB. Not sure what Dante's doing right now. So while we're still waiting on him, I'm gonna take a look at the losers bracket and see what's going on there. So we still have to wait on the match between Iron Zangief and Bloodbath McGrath. I'm assuming this is because that Iron Zangief's probably in the middle of a Grand Blue match, if I had to guess. Because Iron Zangief.
Apparently, Bloodbath had internet issues, I think, earlier.
Ah.
So
if we could just get... Alright, so anyway, the winner of that will go on to fight Mr. David Swoops, and the winner of that goes on to fight Vitality. And then we also have a matchup between Gorgameth and Big Moisture to occur in Losers Round 4. And that's about in terms of like how the Losers Bracket's probably gonna turn out. Mistopheles almost in a position to put himself as a potential champion of DP10, but he still has two very formidable threats that could get in the way of him and an easy $100.
Yeah, we determined what we're doing as far as the breakdown. Sorry.
Probably just gonna give it the first.
Gotcha.
Simple. It's like doing 50 for first and then trying to divide another 50 between three players, like.
Oh, I was just thinking like 70 first, 30 second, but understandable.
Okay, so apparently Dante's game crashed, so that was the thing that happened.
Yeah, if it crashes, it'll sometimes get locked in a screen that looks right, and you'll just never receive the invite.
David Swoops, thank you for becoming a disciple, dude. Alright. A strange array of technical issues on the production and player side. This is what it is. Alright, we're gonna give Dante just a little bit more time. Yeah, he's saying in the Discord that SF5 hates us today. There's... truer words have never been spoken.
Yeah, it's really unfortunate. This was supposed to be the big Dragon Punch Online, and everyone's internet has just been trash.
Yep, to varying different degrees and to varying different problems. Yeah, Evo and CBT Online, let's not forget about the... Oh, God.
It is what it is.
Oh, yeah, so Training Stage is really banned during CBT Online. Why?
I have full and reasonable faith that Capcom is doing everything in the best interest of the players of Street Fighter V.
Oh, they're convinced people count squares when that's not that happened.
Was that like a thing in 4?
It's an online tournament. I could take a magic marker, draw on my monitor, and count squares.
But also not all the stages look like training stage.
Right.
I could make all of the characters look like Zangief. It doesn't matter.
Also, yeah, that's the other thing about CBT this year. Like, not only is it like we're doing CBT online, but Capcom Cup is still going to be in person. But they've moved it from France, where it was going to be, back to the U.S. And oh my god. Alright, so Dante says that he's ready. I'm gonna send him an invite again.
We just think it's gonna be in person.
Yeah.
As if this will ever end.
See, really, this is the way how fighting games are gonna look like from here on out.
All hail good netcode. Down with everything else.
We will worship our thems, fighting herds, overlords.
Everyone play Skullgirls.
That's the weirdest FGC timeline that could have happened. If you were to tell me in 2019 that 2020 EVO was going to be MK11, thems, fighting herds, Skullgirls, and what was the other one?
I
have no idea.
KI.
Oh, yeah, MKI. I would have called you a liar, and I would have bet thousands of dollars on that.
And you would have lost thousands of dollars.
If you remember the crawling back to me meme from like 2018, that's KI right now.
I'm actually kind of hyped to see KI though.
KI's gonna be dope.
Exciting.
Like, honestly, all those games in those open brackets are gonna be sick.
Especially for me, it's like KI and Skullgirls, because like the people who really love that game to start with just never stopped playing it.
Right.
Right.
So you get to see like a glimpse of the meta, like 3-4 years on.
Actually, very impressive. Raw Tatsu at the start, going back into it. Seb Man versus THCB, wearing the costume of champions in order to be a champion.
Internet strategies are everything you want to be and more.
Yep.
These two have played a handful of times, and I don't think THCG has ever clutched it out against Deadman.
Like, but looking at it right now!
Oh my god.
Round two. That's the dream that online Kens are always looking for. They just want to start with a raw toss through at the beginning of the round.
And have it all work out.
Just have it all work out.
That's a Dante special right there.
Who dares jump that?
Fire off the Nantai area.
Dante feels like he's already in 7-7.
I wouldn't go that far.
You don't think so?
We're in round two, my dude. Good cross cut, or cross up throw.
And a converted off the stand, heavy punch.
He's answering everything.
THCB could have just been normal DP, and with the meter gain, he would have had super available to cancel into.
And also not a fan of him walking forward after the Sedman destroyed the can. THCB with a considerable life lead, decides to raw Tatsu again.
Deciding that he's gonna die the way he lived. Ooh, good EX Fireball.
Very good.
A lot of birdies and Sedman in particular will like to use sweep as a whiff trap because birdie gets that.
No.
And THCB said, no, eat this fireball.
Alright, so THCB going
pretty
up.
Convincing game one. That was pretty convincing.
Yeah, Dante's looking real good right now. We'll see if Sedman can draw on his years of Netflix experience and
claw his way out.
What adaptation will Stedman make?
More can.
more chain, more can. Crouch medium punch.
Air.
Good fireballs on PhD's cart right there.
And the pokes. Footsies with the sweep.
Banana in place for the DPO to go through it.
I feel like that was just perfect timing that the banana disappeared the moment PhDB went over it. Because I think there's a spot there where Sakura would actually have gotten hit by the banana.
That would have been hilarious.
I've watched 500 too few hours in this game to even see that situation.
Oh, the low forward.
No.
Just out of range to get another conversion.
Round two.
Not quite able to connect.
Anti-air with the crouch medium punch.
Punishing the whiff. That man able to get the side switch.
Thought they getting the side switch with the back throw.
Anti-air.
Solid anti-air. Yeah, Dante trying to keep it simple. To which Zedman responds with EX Dolphin Dive.
And light kick out of the V reversal. A little cheeky, but it works.
And eats the grab. Oh!
Oh,
no.
EX Chain right through the fireball.
More can, more chain.
More can, more chain.
More can, more chain. More consistent anti-airs. Like he's starting to catch those jumps.
Beautiful display of adaptation from Mr. Setman.
It's one game. Who can adapt or counter-adapt or just do what's unexpected?
So that's what the costume code does. Oh, God.
Went for the shimmy, but the men didn't quite.
The first of the fireball, but not the second. A little too far away.
Ooh, okay.
Interesting. All right.
Rip.
What?
Oh, what?
Rip.
Well, that's not good.
Oh no. You know what? I'm gonna host Dog.
Yeah. That sucks.
That's very unfortunate.
I felt like it was right after the change in momentum.
Yep.
Oh, now challenge is dying on me, please.
Challenge is dying on you?
It has been all day.
Oh, no.
This had to be the tournament where there was money on the line.
This had to be the tournament. Oh, God.
If you announce the pot after the tournament, this one.
If we announce the money later. Oh, God. Not like this.
The spirits of online fighting games are just not pleased.
Not like this.
Online fighting game tournament must be Evo. Time to DDoS myself.
I'm so embarrassed. I am so sorry.
Okay, so how do we want to do this? Do we... 1-1.
What can we do other than replay game 3?
Replay game 3.
Okay.
Like, round 1 of game 3 hadn't closed out yet. We don't.
Oh, that's right. Didn't. Did it?
Nope.
No, it was probably about to in Dante's favor, but...
Yep.
It was... That combo wasn't going to quite kill, so we can't say for sure.
Okay.
All we can do is just play game 3.
Just play it out. I'm gonna go to the back of the queue. If the stream dies, at least the matches go. God, I am.
Game three.
I am so mad.
That's right. That's just more data for both players. They've had some time to rethink, reanalyze. We're gonna see better play now.
Or it's completely cracked their mental.
Shush.
Opting for the birdie skin change. Thinking the purple might give him just that little bit extra.
Fight for
power. I don't even know what's going on near Burden's mouth, so it looks like a broken texture. Dante starting off strong.
Don't know if Sakura gets a dash stand light kick though when she blocks Chain.
If he's perfect, I saw him do it earlier. I think he has to be like perfectly ranged. Oh,
oh. Wait, the
XDP to prevent the stun.
Tried to do the back pierce to call out the back dash, but just a little out of range. He missed the anti-air, and that caused him to have a knockdown, which is unfortunate. There, there, by Sudman, and THCB just lets it rip. This is an uphill battle for THCB now. Yeah.
Ends with a kick to the toes.
Man's on game point here. With THDB in the corner, he's looking good. THDB trying to fight his way out.
Doing what he can.
Boom, jump in. And set man in sleep.
Hard throw, now birdie's in the corner. All the way from the can to the dolphin battle connect.
Definitely looking for that. We're gonna guess for game situation here.
Oh,
what an air.
Calls it out. That'll be enough. Sudman takes it 2-1.
Huh. Hate to see it.
Yeah, that feels a little bit bad. The unfortunate nature of online tournaments.
David Swoops is going to wash his hands before he's on stream. Doesn't make much sense because he's about to get them dirty with this play.
Who's next?
It's gonna be David Boots and Bloodbath.
Okay.
Bloodbath, apparently Bloodbath going to losers earlier because he did not show up in time.
That is correct.
Yeah, so on the loser side of this bracket, the winner of this match, David Swoops versus McGrath, will go to Vitality. And then on the other side of losers, THTB versus Dark Zero.
No, I thought those two played earlier, but I'm wrong. Don't listen to me.
Dark Zero was sent to losers by Mistopheles.
Tony Breaker, or Tony Baker, not Tony Breaker, in that last match we just saw.
Holy Tony Breaker.
Holy Tony Breaker.
That sounds like a combo from like an 80s arcade game, like a beat 'em up. Like the Tony Breaker.
Let's do this.
It's a Tony Baker like a equivalent of Shaq
like
Fu.
Like a really scuffed Streets of Rage.
It's a Tony Baker equivalent of Shaq Fu.
There you go.
I'm kind of down.
So, David Sloops is definitely going to play Abigail. I'm not sure who Bloodbath is going to play.
Going with the Alex.
Okay. We've seen Bloodbath pull out four different characters in the bracket, so you never really know.
One of them wild ones.
Fucking Bloodbath just going ham. That doesn't matter if you're a farmer.
He's a man with nothing to lose.
These two are so gormless right now, I don't even know what to say. They're just hitting buttons.
How does this make you feel, Corey?
I hate it, but I love it. Ooh. Missed the punish.
Oh,
nothing
no.
To do that. Got hit by the cross up. Usually best to just block the unblockable. Just take it. The scaling's super heavy. Not much they can do about it. Ooh. They're just slamming buttons. I get it.
The word safety doesn't exist in this. The frames aren't real.
Look at this.
Listen, if I occupy the space with my fists, he can't go there, right?
You're right.
Oh. The Hurricane Rana.
Alright, both characters are one hit from death. Oh no. Swoops, not knowing the punisher there, could have ended it. Bloodbath didn't convert into super, but I think he's in chip range now. Oh,
oh god.
What a way to go out. That was almost really bad for Swoops though, because that did almost enough gray life to kill him.
Abigail wins.
Face the camera. It's broke. Robot Abigail takes no prisoners.
No, none at all. Just following his programming.
If you occupy the meter-long space where he's just throwing out punches in front of him, you're gonna get hit.
Round one.
It's just the way it works.
Fight!
I bet both of these players are having a ton of fun right now.
Like, everyone thought they were, like, sick at the fighting game of their youth. But realistically, it looks something more like this.
Bloodbath went for the wake-up normal move, and he died for it.
Nashed right back into the arms of Abigail.
Round two.
He was just trying to get up to Abigail's chest to hug him.
Abigail! Is probably more of a hugger than I give him credit for, but also not someone you want to be hugged by. You could probably say the same for Alex. Or anyone in the roster of this game, actually.
Good crush counter on Bloodbath's part. But didn't convert. I wonder if there was a lag spike or something there. Just the raw DDT and it worked out to keep the run. It was actually really smart. I never thought about that.
And that's it.
That's amazing.
breaks the fourth wall like Shaq breaks the backboard. Abigail wins.
And on we go.
2-0. David swoops. I'm taking your points and leaving on to Vitality.
All right, and we are in top six. Sitting in winners' finals is Subman and Mr. Mistopheles. In losers' semis on one side, we have Ultimate Vitality versus David Swoops, and on the other, it's THTB and Dark Zero Omega.
Yeah, coming up next, we've got Vitality versus David Swoops. Now, on an entirely different Twitch channel, but that's all right. The nature of running tournaments in this time.
Streaming's a blow-up. No way around it.
The safe end of the quarantine cannot come soon enough.
Ain't that the truth?
But for now, it's just what we have to live with. So now we get to see the true matchup of David Swoops versus Ultimate Vitality. Abigail versus Jury.
I can't think the time these two have really played, but it should be a good match.
I know I haven't seen it, but it'll be interesting to see what sort of adaptations come out, because Jury's a character that can get a lot of damage off of each trigger one, and Abigail's a character who has a lot of damage inherently.
I was about to say, Abigail's 51 damage.
Yeah.
Or classic Jury's.
But I guess what would be most interesting is, like, Jury's pretty mobile, but I feel like a lot of her options still get just answered by the fact Abigail's incredibly tall and hits a bunch of awkward things. So it'll be interesting to see how this matchup happens. And we'll get some early charges in. Good damage. Ooh, able to get the pinwheel out.
This right here is where Abigail struggles, just because his buttons are so slow and his defensive options. He doesn't have a reversal or free frame.
Yeah, it's super hard for him to break out the pressure that Ultimate Vitality is more than happy to provide.
And you can see, at any point, Swoops could have done a V reversal to get out of pressure, but he wanted the V trigger, because that's a very powerful comeback mechanic.
Yeah, and he probably would have needed it at that point. Armor tanks. The side switch will be met with the tire. But Jury's getting a slight damage lead on each of these trades.
Is it really worth it, though?
Yeah, you have to say at this point, like, even if Abigail's got slightly less percentage, I'm pretty sure Abigail just straight up has more health.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
One Jury V-trigger one popped.
Ooh, and threw himself into the corner. You hate that. That's going to be the game right there, I think. For the round, at least. Yep,
that'll take it.
Damage. That's post V-trigger activation, too. That's crazy.
Shiny eye right to
the corner.
Especially versus Abigail.
Especially versus Abigail. See, what Vitality should be doing when Swoops is going for the tires, just dash up and throw. The throw animation is invulnerable.
Yeah. You
don't have to deal with the tire.
Opting to try to punish with V-skill every time. Oh, V-trigger 1 to get him out of the EX, but...
Tires.
It's just occupying all the right space.
Oh, look at that.
EX will find its way through. Punches to answer.
Ooh, and that might be game right there.
Vitality!
Good kill.
Oh, tries to jump it.
You lose. David serves with game one.
Some vitality I have to look and recognize that trying to answer the tire with V-Skill just isn't working how you want it to. You can do that. I still opt for going with the throw. You have more than enough time. That tire takes forever to come out.
Yeah, it's all like... Because, like, you can cancel Dury's V-Skill, so if he really wanted to, he could get fancy with it and cancel it to get the throw from pretty much any distance. Now that might be kind of finicky. I don't know exactly what frames that gives you.
Well, like right there, even at that range, he had enough time to dash up and throw, I think.
Ooh, okay. In the corner, gets good damage. Abigail's gonna find his way out.
One of the benefits of when you're in the corner and you go for a jump, if your opponent goes for like a kick throw setup, you'll usually get hit by the jab, air reset, but because your opponent is already committed to the throw, you'll usually get to land and just jab them.
Yeah. The EXDP will get vitality out of the round. No bar to spend. Grab will connect. Yeah, with no tire there, the V-Skill working out a bit better. Trying to get stunning. Ooh, EX Pinwheel! Connects in the air. What will Vitality find?
You can see Swoop's packing a lot of throws, which should be a signal to Vitality to go for a shimmy.
I'll take it. DP connects, and game two to Vitality. Second round looking particularly good. Go to game three for a spot in top four. Answers the tire call with quick pinwheel.
Ooh, good crush counter. You have to time that real specific so you hit Abigail when the armor ends. Oh, was that a punish? That might have been a punish. Which is something, not every character gets to punish EX Abigail punch like that.
Yeah, Drury with long legs. That medium kick coming out pretty quickly.
Oh, is he gonna land on the tire?
But not getting anything out of it.
Probably could have charged the trigger and hit him after the tire juggle.
Ooh.
Oh, that's fine. That's what you want.
Breaks the armor. Oh, it jumps over him. All right.
Yep, just block it. Ooh, good on Swoops for being able to block the instant air overhead when Vitality came back down. Not many players even know about that.
Vitality connects on the other side, though, and takes round one. Ooh, running up and sweeping.
Yeah, that's better than what he was doing. We'll take it.
Yeah, the adaptation from Vitality coming through. Ooh, only getting one hit of the X-Zones.
Double overhead.
Oh.
You can't throw that. It's not the answer.
Oh, thought he'd get more off the projectile. Final round. Spawn top four, who's gonna earn it? Hey, able to connect with another pinwheel. No V-trigger to get him out of that safely.
Didn't have to punch into a tire setup. Oh, that's just brutal, but Vitality finds his way out with the jump.
Turning Street Fighter into a puzzle platformer, one tire at a time.
I'd almost say that Swoops isn't really trying to play, he's just trying to get as many tires on the screen as possible. Oh no, why'd you jump?
Okay, that's so much damage. Tries to get a punish on the dash! Oh, he doesn't block it, and that's the end!
Well, that one was kind of inevitable, because he could have still done super, and despite it being so scaled, it still probably would have killed.
Rough one. Swoops able to come out on top, 2-1.
Next up, I think we're going to have Sedman versus Mr. Mistopheles.
Yeah, playing out Winners Finals. Seed 1 versus Seed 2. A tournament winner versus someone who, if they don't run into Corey, probably would be a tournament winner. This should be a good one.
This one is going to be first to three.
First three. All right, so Akuma versus Birdie. We haven't seen this so far today, but I feel like this has to have happened before.
Well, even in Toledo, this is like the normal Toledo Grand Finals for their weeklies, because it's usually Kenstar versus Mr. Mistopheles.
Yeah, Kenstar also a Birdie player. So Mistopheles has experience in the matchup.
Yeah, but according to him, and I can see why, this matchup is kind of rough for Akuma. So we'll see what happens. The last Dragon Punch Online, Mistopheles lost to two different Birdies, one being Kenstar, the other being Sedman.
No.
Ooh, and Sedman starting with the double command grab
into a regular grab.
Ooh, missed the punish there.
Birdie has to have, like, one of the best matchup spreads in the game, right? Like,
It's very good.
Like, he's probably not like quite a top 5 character right now, but his matchup spread is incredible.
There's a lot of debate in the Street Fighter 5 community on how good Birdie still is.
Gets tricky with the banana, and he's gonna pop the super early.
He's gonna get Oki off of this. And he baited the XDP.
What's his punish? What's his punish? So much of Akuma's life is gone.
Oh, and
there goes the rest.
FYI, everybody, we just received another donation for the pot. It's not 150. I'm probably going to do a 70-20-10 split since it's this large.
Yeah. That man with all the answers. Incredible punish.
Now the pot's super reaching a point where I can't justify just giving it to the first place winner.
It's almost more money than an Evo 8th place.
But But a quick game one for Sudman.
Yeah, especially that round two. Lasophilis answering back. We've seen him in some tricky spots before, but he's a player who can learn and find his way out of them.
You just saw Mistopheles doing a ton of pressure, but Sedman just keeping it safe and blocking through it all. Until he found the one opening to activate V-Trigger and bust himself out of the corner.
Can on screen.
More can, more chain.
More can, more chain. Replacing the tire with something smaller, but arguably as effective. Dolphin will connect.
Dolphin dive.
Birdie came to play. Got the meter advantage, too.
Oh, it's basically even.
Is it still even?
Well, no, but...
Makuma's health halved by that series.
Lot of damage. Good anti-air. Another 8
no.
Pull. Quick 2-0. Still one more game. This is winner's final, so it is first to three.
I have to say, Sedman so far looking very good. The Dark Auto versus Donuts. An eternal battle. And they know it's a best of five, right?
They should know it's first to three. I wonder if Mistopheles is going for a character swap, but that seems very unlikely. Did he? No, yeah, he's still in here.
Skin swap, maybe? I don't know.
Who's in losers, Ken? It's David Swoops versus THDB. That's who's going to be next, and the winner of that's going to fight the loser of this.
Yeah, so our top four, Birdie, Akuma, Abigail, Sakura. How many of those characters are you happy to put on the
thing? Sakura's pretty good. That's about the only one I'm happy to put on.
You used to play soccer for a while, didn't you?
For a little bit, yeah, and when Season 3 came out, I was messing around with her, and then Kage happened. What a mistake that was.
But did you have fun?
It was okay.
Okay. Alright. I'll take what I can get.
Looking back at it, I remember a lot of complaining from myself.
That was around the time I started playing the game, so I remember a decent amount complaining too. Ooh, Tatsu to get over the can. An awkward punish, but we'll take it.
Oh, goodness,
that was with a fireball instead of a button.
You have to still be careful about that. I think Birdie can still anti-air Akuma air fireball. He just has to be a little bit more on point to do so.
Yeah. Kick will connect. Here's him far, far away. Oh! Drops the heel.
That was quite far for the overhead. I'm surprised that reached, actually.
Probably caught a bit of Akuma's linesman.
Was a little too late with that anti-air on Sudman's part. But he didn't take too much damage for it, honestly.
Yeah. Birdie.
Oh, he's in the corner, and this is real bad.
Oh, but he gets it right back out. They both have all the meter they could want.
Anti-air on Mustafli's part, but no follow-up.
I have to assume Mistopheles looking for one of those combo sends in Super. Alright, get it there.
Both characters, one hit away from death.
Only Submans can send his opponent to losers.
What a commitment. Wow, that's crazy. I can't believe he went straight into the DP. I have to imagine that was a fireball and that just worked out. I don't think Akuma's crouching medium kick is really that hit confirmable. Maybe I'm wrong.
Hard to say. Especially online. Birdie playing a good version of Keep Out, but he's gonna miss the Dolphin Dive. He's gonna miss the X Bull Rush.
Of course he does.
Hey, Mistopheles starting to get his pressure back. Doesn't get hit by the cross up. Got the life lead.
A lot of damage for command.
But there it goes.
Ooh, and that might be game.
I think it is.
Way
he goes.
2-1.
He's not happy going to losers just yet. If at all.
No one's ever happy going to losers.
True. I just spent a lot of time there, so I don't think my... I don't think my mindset changes much. I guess technically I spend as much time in winners as losers, but you know, it's fine.
0-2.
Someone's gotta do it.
25% of people have to. Ooh, and Mistopheles accidentally put himself in the corner. You just don't want to be there. Ever.
Not ver-
Good whiff punish on Mistopheles.
Ooh, going for the later conversion off of Demon Flip. Still gonna block it. Ooh, answers V trigger one.
You gonna see a demon setup? We might.
Good damage. V trigger one runs out.
You can see Sedman jumping, trying to bait out Super. Or anything, really.
Yeah, Kuma roughly in the space to chip there anyway. But. Mistopheles is able to take it more cleanly and keep his meter. Submen, good punish.
Ooh, Submen missed the punish on the air fireball.
Get the grab. Aoki gets him nothing. Oh, but that does.
Looking good. I didn't realize Freddy could do that.
I feel like I learn something new every time I see Sedman's Birdie.
Wonder if he could have converted into something there.
Whether it be that banana setup from game one or... Ah, right there.
And this is where it gets hard. Anytime Birdie successfully gets the can down, it's just so hard to deal with it.
And he hit on Akuma at the end of this round.
Oh yeah.
Mistopheles has all the meter, literally all the meter in the world. V trigger one available. And he'll use it. And then
that Oki is not real.
Yeah, eat a credit. Eat a crouching light punch. Meter even. Life, Sedman's advantage. But can he close him out?
Block sweep.
Going for the super early. Tons of damage. Come out of third health. Warning.
A little rough on the stop leads. He has to make a huge comeback, and that's going to be it. 3-1. 4-7.
Birdie just puts hands on him. Seven man will await. Grand finals.
Next up, we're going to have David Swoops versus THTB. This will be a first to two.
Get to see some Abigail. They're
already in here. So let's go.
Winner of this faces Mistopheles. Winner of that, back to Subman. And have we seen this? Yeah, we already saw this in Winner's Side, where THTB took it 2-0 over David Swoops. So...
Yeah, THTB sent Swoops into losers in the first place, so this is the run back.
I remember it being fairly convincing when he did it, so... Hopefully David Swoops has found some sort of answer. So we can find out who will make it into the top three and get a part of this prize pool.
Beefy prize pool. 150 yeah. bucks.
Blossomed. More and more money has been on the line as the night has gone on. They've earned their character's face on the graphic. Now they need to earn some money in their pockets. Abigail versus Sakura.
Wow, I can't believe that flip went right over the fireball like that. That was such a perfect timing sort of thing.
Yeah, and opting for a tire to start it off, which is pretty reminiscent of the set we saw earlier.
Mm-hmm.
The issue we saw is he pretty much only used it one or two times that entire set. Now calling for it, the grab will get him through.
You saw THTB go for the throw there when Swoops laid down the tire. That is the better solution, in my opinion.
Definitely what you would preach.
Because when you do the throw, you just don't have to do it. You go past it.
Yeah, the DP gets answered by the tire.
Ooh, big call out on the B skill.
That's not okay.
That was good.
Forgot about that conversion. Mm-hmm. And Swoop's able to take around on. Unfortunately for Dante, once the tire's out, he's not getting the conversion he wants to on these jump-ins. XCP will get him through.
I don't know if Soccer gets dashing Oki after EXCP.
Okay, opting to go high.
With the button there.
A little bit of lag, but he gets the damage. David Swoops in the corner. Dante gets stunned.
Sakura's VT1 this season, and I think they buffed it. It is really strong for a 2-bar VT. Just gives her so many plus frames, so many opportunities for your opponent to make a mistake.
Ooh. Did that OTG?
Oh, so yeah, if you don't quick Rebecca Rise.
Crazy. Oh, wow. Man, from the fireball and eats the DP too. The slugfest.
Oh, got hit. Oh, that could have been death.
Oh no.
I hate to see it happen.
David swoops with game one. Feels like he's found his answer. It definitely wasn't clean enough where you can't say Dante's can definitely win this set.
I mean, CHTB did send him to losers in the first place.
Feels like he definitely has more of an answer. Calling in more tires. Taking advantage of the defense that the setup provides.
Wow, that fireball was just out of range to actually hit him.
Knock the tire right into him. Good pressure. He side swaps himself. Oh no.
It gets 99 hits of armor. You can't do that.
Actually 99?
I think so.
Yikes.
Or maybe that was in an old patch. I can't remember.
That's like that is a comedic amount of armor.
Right? I think I want to say they made it 99 because it was originally like infinite armor, but there was some weird bug with it.
Yeah, that sounds like something that would happen.
Oh, that sucks, but luckily Swoops didn't tech the knockdown, so THTB was not punished for it.
Not quite enough damage.
Dagger crouched medium kick to take that round.
HC fighting for his tournament life. Loses on the trade, but gains the pressure. Can you land on the tire after that throw?
Off of a normal throw or like a command throw?
Off of that one, the one where he throws in there.
No.
Okay.
I don't think you get any juggles off of it.
Because I've never seen it, so I'm just curious.
Oh, good shimmy, but no conversion.
Ooh, gets a stun, though. Dante brings it right back. Sakura wins. 1-1. Fighting for a spot in Losers Finals. A spunky tomboy versus the personification of an SUV. And maybe David Swoop's looking for a character swap?
Color swap, more than anything.
Maybe not liking the Monsters, Inc. This is game three. Need the breather? Now's the time to take it.
They're actually fighting for $15 right now.
$15 and a chance at even more.
But they both get the character on the graphic, so they're all winners.
A bump up on that numerical statistic you've been keeping track of? Picture's face on the bracket? Or on the graphic?
I think Bryce has a stat on that.
Yeah.
Again, with the staggered crouching medium kicks, they're working out a lot, but THTB isn't hit confirming off of them. Good flip to get over the fireball.
Little air to air there. Another one.
Never let Abigail EX Abigail punch in your face. It's like minus. It's at least minus 5, I know that, but I think it's more.
Ooh, jumps.
Jump. Why'd you jump back?
EXCP, can he recover? With normal grabs.
Alright, well, the.
Oh.
Was over, but got clipped on the jump in.
No meter to play with for Dante. EX Abigail punches, connects.
But he did.
Air to air.
That's interesting. I think Swoop's like, I'm done with the tires. Just gonna put my pedal to the metal.
Tires, what got him to this position in the first place?
True. But THCB's been pretty good with checking the tires. Oh, and the dash, but no confirm.
Oh, not quite out of range. David Soups will take it. 2-1. Guaranteeing himself a little bit of the pot. And the chance to fight for a lot more. Just to get back a bit. There has to be something to say. To regardless of whether your opponent is checking an option like tire, that just throwing it out makes them have to think more. Like,
yeah, but there's a balance. There's a balance to it.
Yeah, you don't want to get reckless with it because then you'll get punished. But when presented the option, it's probably a good idea to keep it out there.
And challenge is being terrible for me right now, so I can't update the bracket quite yet, but it is going to be Mistopheles versus David Swoops in a 1-3.
Yep. Winner faces Subman in grand finals.
Yes. Yes, David Swoops, this is a 1-3.
Will it be the Abigail or the Akuma to answer the birdie?
Well, I will say, this is not the format Swoops usually plays. He specializes in 1-1s. So he might be a little out of his element.
A man in the business of running away with your points. But he's currently in the position where he might just run away with this pot. Ooh, doesn't keep blocking the tire. Doesn't answer the Abigail punch.
Oh, that was a messed up cross up.
Ooh, alright.
Stared at him and then punched him in the mouth.
You aren't gonna press a button. Or do any of those other things Akuma can do. You're just gonna eat it. And he was right.
Good punish on the stand heavy punch. Ooh, got shimmied.
So close to stun. But doesn't quite have the range. He's in the corner versus Abigail. gets himself out with a demon flip. This is scary for both of them. Abigail with the V trigger. It's gonna pop the super. I don't think that's gonna.
It
definitely
might
not
kill.
Enough.
It might kill.
So close. Way closer than I thought was gonna be, honestly.
Wow.
David Swoops takes game one.
And the jab after the throw tech.
Scaling does nothing to that super. That thing hits like a truck.
Well, it was only two hits beforehand, True. So he's doing 80% of its damage.
Still.
This monstrosity of a character. Man versus machine.
Is Akuma really a man? Like, he's a man in the physical sense, but he's like some Dark Hado nightmare demon, right?
It's true.
He's like your sleep paralysis monster.
Oh, no check on the flip. That everyone needs to work on checking that flip. It's plus on block, but you get a free crush counter if you can interrupt it, and it's not the hardest thing to react to, all things considered.
Tire gets him out of the original issue, but okay.
Didn't block it.
All the damage he wants, tries to teleport out. Abigail's gonna get to calm the tire. That. Oh no! He jumps it!
Every time Abigail does that, the scene in Avengers Endgame where Thanos just says, "I am inevitable," pops into my head. Maybe that was Infinity War.
I just think of videos of buses getting hit by trains. In a scene we've played out many times tonight. Almost the tail of the tournament, that. Jumping right into it. Mistopheles answering back, gets a stun. Definitely not done yet.
Super. I don't.
Getting a little bit of greedy there.
That's too bad.
Gets another shot with a feature one, but the EX Demon Flip will answer.
Answers that. Huh.
That's kind of unexpected. I kind of expected him to get creamed.
But... yeah, I didn't know that was an answer.
Okay.
I get the mix. And whipping me like he did, charge it all the way. Flip over the sweep, counter hit combo into corner carry. Will he go for the tire? He will. Ooh, that's gonna be a DP. Does not care about the tire.
Yeah, that's an invincible reversal.
Ooh. Like a button.
Oh, rolls forward, run to Akuma, and I'll be stunned.
Yeah, that's gonna be death.
Game 2 to Mistopheles.
1-1 here. All tied up.
And away he goes like the Iron Giant. Sailing off into the sky. Got Akuma playing the part of Paul Bunyan. Abigail playing the part of the machine.
Yeah.
Wait, that's not Paul Bunyan. I don't remember which one that is, but...
oh, I know who you're talking about. I can't remember his name either, though. But the dude, while he beat the machine, he later died because he beat the machine.
Seems fitting.
Yeah.
A perfect to David Swoops.
Oh, good awareness to do the back heavy punch into pretty much anything that would beat just one hit of armor.
Yeah, Is this one perfect for another?
Might answer back his own perfect.
Oh, nope. Not quite. Oh, okay.
Wow, reached, okay.
Okay!
Oh, man.
So much damage. In a precarious position, what looked like a perfect.
Oh, good.
Is now anything but.
Teleport, but not ready for it the second time.
No answer to the second one. David Swoops taking game three. Moving on to 2-1 the set. And one game away.
All right, Jared.
For grand finals. Mistopheles opting for the breather. Got him a game versus Seb Man. Can it get him the rest of the set versus Swoops? Think it over. Akuma's got answers to a lot of the options in this game. It's up to Mistopheles to find his. This runaway train that is David Swoops' Abigail. So it's a tale of the tournament tonight. People jumping. V-Trigger 1.
It's messed up, though. Like, you want to jump it, because if you successfully jump it, you get a free, like, 20 to 30% punish. But you have to be so on point, and you have to know whether the Abigail player is going to charge it or not charge it. Even though I say you should just block it, there are many times where I challenge it, even though I shouldn't. It's very seductive to try and challenge.
Your natural tendency.
It's like, at that moment, Abigail is an anglerfish, and she's dangling.
Ooh! Good answer.
I'm pretty sure it does.
I want to say it does.
I think it's full body and armor. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure that's the case.
I'm pretty sure I've seen it eat sweeps before, so... Mistopheles getting that first round.
Starting off strong with the corner carry into the shimmy, into the meaty.
The stun! Good amount of meter, not enough to end with anything going into super, but... Not quite enough!
Damage! Oh, and the Ooh. Death.
He finds his way out this time. That brings it to 2-2. Mistopheles with only one blown save on his record. And we'll close the game out that time.
These guys, Oh, never mind. I was about to say, we already established a playing for $15 here.
The loser gets 15. The winner plays for even more.
The winner gets at least 30.
That 10%? No, that's 20%, yeah.
Yeah, I'm gonna do a 70-20-10.
Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
But,
So winner gets 105.
Yep, 105.
Wow. Just looking at these two characters standing near each other.
Stares at him in the face. David Swoop says no to the pressure and just armors through it. a flip on block, it's plus two, I believe. I know it's plus, but I think it's specifically plus two.
What is pressure to this mass of metal?
Hey, good job staying crouched for the demon flip grab. You have to make a read there if you're not ready to anti-air it.
Oh no!
Raw. Abby punch. After the air reset.
Abby's feet hits the ground and then so does Akuma.
Game point for David Sloops here.
Backwards rolls. Stay just out of range. Make Akuma chase, maybe a bit too much.
Wow, the whiff trap, run into punch into Abby punch, that's crazy.
Very little meter for the Abigail, but he's got a good life lead.
Look at that patience from Swoops, just sit there and block it.
Any life lead can melt in the face of Akuma.
Oh, this is real bad.
Demon Swoops so far. Playing the way he needs to.
Swoops just pushing buttons, just trying to get something through. Nope, this is Mustafa's chance to tie it up here. And he got hit. Oh,
good setup. As much meter as he wants. The next hit will take the game. At least the round.
Oh my
god. He'll find it.
This is why you take the throw.
Final round. Game 5.
Oh, that's going to be a lot of damage. Will he go into super? Yeah, I think that's the right call. You just want to melt that health as much as possible at the start.
The game starts and Akuma's already at a third of his HP.
Is that
now
it?
Even less. Any hit.
The shimmy. What did that happen?
Can Mesophiles claw all the way back? That's the V trigger. The fireballs won't connect this time.
Punish the sweep with the sweep. Ooh. Answer the jump in with the parry.
The DP will connect. In a good position. Well, as good of a position as you can be with literally 5 health.
This is so tense right here.
David Swoops will not have the option to chip him out. He won't get enough meter.
And
he finds it.
Crouching medium kick. Ooh, what a set.
David Swoops.
I was
on to grand finals. Impressive display. Man. Falling to machine.
An Abigail mirror.
Progress marches on.
Am I going to have to put 2 Abigails on the graphic tomorrow?
You just might.
Oh, I hope not. I kind of do. But I feel like, given everything that's happened tonight with the internet issues, ending it with an Abigail mirror seems like justice.
You didn't realize it, but during the downtime, I actually switched out the stream. This is actually just the junkyard. It's all Abigail, all the time. Said man, a few different characters, actually. He's, what, Birdie, Yif, Abigail?
Yeah, those are the 3 I've seen him play in tournament. Actually, David. I don't think I've ever seen him play any other characters.
David Swoops, so far, shown to be an Abigail loyalist. Subman will have his pick.
I'm pretty sure Subman's just gonna go with Abigail for the culture.
Subman in a really good position to take his first Dragon Punch.
For the winner of this match will get 105. Whoever loses will get 30. And then whoever gets, or Mistopheles, 115.
David Soup's going on pretty good run this tournament. Fighting back from losers round two to make it all the way to Grands.
We are doing it.
But the tiny health bar of Akuma is no longer a benefit to him. Yes, fight with.
I'm glad that more of rock.
These high health characters.
This is the state of online Street Fighter V in 2020.
Look at how much space on the screen these characters occupy. It doesn't matter what stage they're playing on, they all look the same. It's just occupied by meat. Calls him the tire.
Ethan does.
But it will not save him.
What is this?
Someone would describe this as beautiful. I am not that person, but someone would. Oh!
It is something.
It's Street Fighter V, baby.
Empty jump super did not work.
Okay. A little bit ambitious there from Sedman.
Abby punch to stop the Abby run. They just tried to fist bump each other.
Oh, okay.
I don't even know how to commentate this. I'm sorry.
I'd say just get excited, but
yeah.
I feel like you're not happy to be here.
I mean, I'm really enjoying this. You're seeing so many weird interactions you don't normally see because of how much armor everybody has.
Telling you, it's just the 300th installment of the Junkyard. Sit back and enjoy the show.
Right! This is the most...
You're watching the most honest matchup in Street Fighter. There's just two characters with giant arms.
Not two characters, two gorillas.
Beating each other up. I mean, I'd be terrified. Silverback gorilla that could call in a giant monster truck tire anytime it wanted. Right to be scared.
Right.
Oh.
What's even the meta for this mirror match?
Wow.
That was actually amazing.
Super whenever you want. Especially as a whiff punish. The meta is press buttons.
Keep charging.
But preferably not the slow ones because they get eaten by the armor. But sometimes the slow ones because they beat some of the other armor.
Oh, right. But because everything has armor, you want to do your multi-hitting moves. But Abigail's multi-hitting moves are like his stand jab and Abby punch, which are, I feel like, aren't the best in the mirror.
Yeah, and thing to note, Sebman is 1-1. And David Swoop is 2-2.
A lot of his moves give more than one hit of armor, so shouldn't you always just be doing an armor move? And hope that your armor lasts longer than the opponent's?
I feel like it's a rock, paper, scissors of armor moves, and I don't know how I feel about that.
You get it.
I mean, they're both, like, relatively monster-sized.
It's
less of a Monster Hunter and more of a Godzilla King of All Monsters.
Yes, yes.
just beating the crap out of each other while all the other characters, much smaller, at their feet. Just like superimpose some skyscrapers in the back, and it's pretty much King of All Monsters.
You're absolutely right.
It's Ghidorah versus Mechagodzilla. They all pretty much had the same moveset anyway, except for when you had lasers versus when you didn't.
Didn't cancel into super there.
Well, I didn't think he needed it. But he might have.
Is he dead? He might be dead.
He's dead. Game 2 to David Swoops 2. Abigail Mears looking quite in his favor. Well, not quite in his favor. He barely lived, but...
If you told me this was how Grand Finals was going to play out, I would not have believed you. 2020 is so weird.
Yeah, but so far, a lot of what you've talked about today is all the bets you would have lost.
That's why I don't bet.
Them's fighting Herds and Evo. We got two Abigails in our Grand Finals. I made a Godzilla King of All Monsters reference.
Flip to go under the neutral jump and cross him up with the tire. That's crazy. That's what I do as Laura. Oh, if you could have juggled off of that in EX Abby Punch. I don't even know which Abigail is which.
I only do because of the colorfulness of one of them.
Wow, even the Abigail tried to jump the Abigail's DT.
Okay. Armor clashes with armor. And then... I don't know.
I'm at a loss for words.
I think you said earlier that it's in God's hands, and that's kind of how I feel.
Now you have to wonder, with Abigail being the mechanic he is, did he help build Mecha Abigail?
I think it's more of like a Terminator situation, where like Mecha Abigail was sent back in time to stop the building of Mecha Abigail. Because even he knew how degenerate he is. I just don't know. Is it the weirdest part of this matchup is like the moments when they're not pressing buttons.
Right, like what's going on in their heads? Other than Burr.
Abigail Rogue go Burr. I like to think it's more of like a calculus that no one would understand.
Okay, like that next level of mathematics that we haven't discovered yet.
I don't know if it's next level or just different.
They don't use frame data. They just use motor oil. Oh, why would you jump? Why would you jump there?
This is like meeting the one other person on your cruise that speaks German. You're just like, in a language no one else understands, and it sounds aggressive. David Swoops takes that one.
Somehow in all that chaos, David Swoop merges the victor and resets the bracket.
The superior birdie with 3-1.
Was it 3-1? I thought it was 3-0.
It was 3-1. It was 3-0. Wow. Okay. The much superior birdie. The expectation is that man switches to birdie, right? Like, no one's crazy enough to run the Abigail mirror twice, right? Right?
I personally want to see it happen, but I don't think Setman will do that. There's like a $70 difference on the line
here.
Yeah,
the difference is $75. How tough are you?
Salty Spittoon. That's really what that whole thing was. Setman was standing outside the Salty Spittoon, gatekeeping David to see how tough he was, to see if he could get in. And he proved correct. That David proved that he could. That he was tough enough.
Now he's standing in front of the Salty Spittoon being like, alright, I'm the bouncer now. And we know that no matter what character you pick, you aren't pretty enough to get in the club. So you're gonna have to beat me up.
Okay, he goes with the birdie. Fun time's over.
Yeah, that birdie skin is definitely not pretty enough to make it in the club. David Swoops switching to Setman's Abigail skin. This has to be like a mental thing. I don't even know what's happening. It feels like everything in this matchup only half works.
But it still gets you over the finish line. That's the messed up part.
The question is who it's going to get over the finish line. And what state they'll be in when they get there.
You know, we just watched like 4 games straight of really slow Abigails. Seeing Birdie do that dolphin dive made it look like he was soaring through the air.
It made it look like he was cheating.
Right.
A whole different game.
Armor doesn't care about chains.
Armor move goes brr. This Abigail has ascended. He has become a real boy, switching from machine to man.
We got hit by the meaty there. I think David was scared of a command grab on his wake up.
Ooh, jumps right over him.
It's so weird. It is so weird watching a matchup and thinking Birdie's a speedy character.
Damn, this Birdie's schmoovin'.
Right, that's...
Yeah, it's strange. Even I got my limits. Yeah, this has been wild. David Swoops maybe going back to his skin, maybe just looking for a little bit of time. Setman, one game up in this grand finals reset. This Birdie versus Abigail matchup.
What a day.
What a day. I didn't wake up this morning and say I was going to cast an Abigail mirror in grand finals. I'm not upset. But I definitely didn't see it coming. Thank you, Vidality. Yeah, this is Battle of the First Seed versus Battle of the Fourth Seed. And everything on the way here.
Man, what a run Swoops has actually had in this
bracket. It's been a great run. Getting the run back on Dante, beating Mistopheles, beating McGrath, Jacket Cheetah. It's been a good tournament for him. And Gorgamath, who got fourth at Queen City Fights, I think?
Yes, he did.
So his day didn't even necessarily start out easy. But does he have something extra for this birdie? Sebman, able to acquire infinite knowledge from the Abigail Mirror. Yikes. Sebman taking another round. I think it was the Abigail Mirror. I think he learned so much from it. It's going to be hard for David Swoops to overcome. He's character knowledge out of his gourd.
I just cannot get over how fast Birdie looks right now.
He's flying. He looks like Rashid. Is this even reactable? Can you see this stuff? I don't even know.
It's like watching a baby gorilla just like swarm around the legs of his opponent. And just like climbing all over his body.
Round one. This is just... I don't know. This is the last game if David Swoops can't win it.
I mean,
a bit lost for answers.
I think it's kind of expected, honestly. I mean, Sebman's Abigail is one of the secondaries. It's not on the same level as his birdie.
Yeah, at the beginning of the day we said pretty likely that Sebman would be joining the list of champions we've had so far for DPO. Oh, but landing on that tire.
Yeah.
Calls in the tire, gets that little bit of extra damage.
I don't think I've ever seen the tire get called in from the other side of the screen like that. I didn't realize it hopped in like it did.
What was that? Don't ask me like I know.
Wow. EX command grab to beat out the Abby punch.
I like to think I have game knowledge above your typical like awful bronze player, but I have no idea what's happening.
That's okay. You know, I'm Grandmaster and I don't have any idea. We're just all here for the ride. The ride that Sedman and David Swoops is taking us on. A beautiful dance.
The unblockable. Not quite enough damage. Calls in the tire and it'll do it. Smart. Dangerous.
On the board. Let's go.
The machine is back.
I just want to point out that if David Swoops wins this, this is the first Cleveland win for DPO.
Alright. Cleveland, exciting. Send David Swoops your energy.
Send this Abigail your energy. You aren't even from Cleveland. Actually, none of us are from Cleveland. I'm unbiased.
Who knew that this Abigail would be the representative of Cleveland scene.
Hey man, someone took the parking brake off. He's been running ever since.
Not the hero Cleveland deserves, mind you, but the hero they need.
Nah, I'd say this is what they deserve. And what they need. Abigail's the answer. Keston proposed it months ago before he left. And here it is right in front of your face.
Swoops is really just the spirit of Keston coming back to us.
I mean, if he wasn't here, do you think Keston would have known to put a little bit more money in the pot? I don't know, man.
Some collusion here.
Oh, so close to stun!
That might be stun.
Yeah. It is! David Swoops, a perfect!
Oh,
game
no.
Four.
Okay, Swoops. I honestly thought this would be a wash, so... You're doing pretty good right now, not gonna lie.
That Hawaiian roller coaster ride from, like, Lilo and Stitch is just playing in my head and I don't know why. It's like watching two waves fight.
Oh, and that should be it. Wow, no cancel into the super. Oh no,
the X Dolphin Dive. Here. Abigail has a chance.
Okay, Abigail actually has to be scared there because
okay.
Ray would have killed him.
Fear okay. Would have served him well. Stepman closes it out. 3-1. He deserves the donut. Now Stepman is able to buy a pretty good big amount donut. Of them.
With this prize money, he could buy a donut that big.
Maybe not that big. He could buy a lot of donuts, though. So the prize pool is 105 to Stepman, 30
yep.
to David Swoops.
And
15
to
Mistopheles.
Well, GG's everyone. We started off pretty rocky, but thank you for joining me on this journey. We made it.
Yeah, legs seemed to pretty much diminish after that first set. I mean, there were spots where it wasn't perfect. I know in Vitality's match there were some issues.
But yeah. But we did it.
Tis the curse playing CFN.
Thanks everyone for participating. We had 45 people total enter this Dragon Punch across all our games, which is a big record-breaking number. I think our previous highest was like 30-something, so let's go. Turns out, you throw money places, people will show up.
Crazy how that works.
Yeah, who knew? But that's all I have. Check out the website. We'll be back. Or check out the website at ohiofgc.com. We'll be back with BPO next week, I assume. Probably.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. I've been Town Crier. He's been Core Jam. Streamed on Queen City Fights by the wonderful Ultimate Vitality. We'll catch you next week.
Peace.
Thanks for watching.